Hey, brothers and sisters, this is Pastor Patrick coming to you from the Philippines. Praise the living God, and I pray that all is well with all who are watching this video. I wanted to ask for a prayer request. I really feel led by the Lord to have a prayer request for a Christian brother, Brother Alex Jones, who is a radio talk show host and filmmaker. Infowars.com is his website. And I had a dream from the Lord about Brother Alex Jones last night. And I will give you the interpretation. When I woke up, the Lord gave me the interpretation. And the Lord is leading me that we should make a video, leading me to make a video that we would pray for Brother Alex Jones. And here's the dream that I had, brothers and sisters. And I'll give the interpretation as I go that I got today from after I woke up. In my dream, brothers and sisters, I was living in a great big mansion, a great big beautiful house. And the interpretation is that was in the church. I was in the church of Jesus Christ. And Alex Jones came to my house. And he came to visit me. And we were talking, and he was asking me and consulting me about some Christian matters. And we were discussing about the end times. And I was advising him on the biblical verses to go along with his talking that he does about the coming New World Order. And what happened is that he noticed that the doors, one of the doors of this mansion, the lock was broken. It looked like it was locked, but it was not locked. And the house was unsecure. Brothers and sisters, listen to me. The house, the mansion that I was living in, was not secure. Talking about the church. And Alex Jones is not a preacher. Now, you know, Alex Jones is an evangelist declaring that the kingdom of the Antichrist is coming to wake everyone up. That's what he does. His mission from God is to wake up the world and the United States and the whole world that the New World Order is coming, the kingdom of Antichrist is coming, and, you know, we need to, it's a call to action, okay? And so there's lots of controversy with that, but, you know, the Lord was showing me it's from the Lord. The job that Alex Jones is doing is from the Lord. It's not the same as, evangelizing people to get saved. He's sounding the alarm and warning, you know, that the kingdom of darkness is coming. And that's exactly what he's doing. And he gets into all the natural details of that manifestation, all the natural things going on in the world that's bringing that. And so in this dream, as I say, brothers and sisters, Alex Jones was the one who saw. I didn't see it. You know, I'm representing as the preacher. I'm representing, you know, an elder in the church or a priest in the church, you know, a pastor in the church. And then here, a shepherd of the flock, an under shepherd of the flock to the Lord. Alex Jones is the one who came in and he saw that the lock was broken. And I was like, there's nothing wrong with it. Then when he got it, showed me, yeah, the lock was broken and needed to be repaired. So what happened is that Alex Jones couldn't reach it, see, and this is where the church comes in. In my dream, you know, in my dream, I didn't know the interpretation. This was as a dream. So in my dream, Alex Jones couldn't reach the door and the lock mechanism to fix it, but he had the tools, and he even borrowed one tool from me. So I gave him a tool. He had his own tools to fix the lock. But what happened is he couldn't reach it. So what I did with one hand, I put my hand, and he stood on my hand, and I lifted him up like this. And then he was able to reach the lock and repair it and everything while he was standing on my hand. I lifted him up. So what does that mean? The interpretation is that I prayed for him. It was the power of the Spirit. And so me representing the church, inside the church there as a under-shepherd, as a preacher, we need to lift him up in prayer. So I lifted him up. And then another thing I wanted to say to you guys and confirming only that, not only that the Lord told me, but in my dream, Alex Jones was only wearing shorts. He was not wearing a shirt. He was not wearing shoes. He had nothing on but a pair of shorts. And so when I woke up and then I started getting the interpretation from the Lord as I asked the Lord and prayed about it and meditating on the dream, I thought, well, he don't have the armor of God on, Ephesians chapter 6. But the Lord said, no, he was exposing himself. Alex Jones is exposing himself to danger and exposing himself to hazards and exposing himself in front of all the religious Pharisee people by going up there fixing that lock, even though he's not a pastor in the traditional sense of being a preacher in the church. He's an evangelist and a watchman. He is a watchman warning of the coming New World Order from the natural view, not the spiritual view like me, okay, and the Lord is leading me to warn people that the kingdom of Antichrist is rising. No, he's looking at all those natural things that's happening, like the martial law and the FEMA camps and all that stuff, and to warn people because, see, brothers and sisters, what a lot of, you know, lots of people who are even Christians, you know, they're carnal-minded. They're not spiritual-minded. They can't catch the spiritual stuff. They don't watch preaching, any of those things. And there's lots of people who are not Christians. But yet they will listen to Alex Jones, and then that's waking them up that, hey, these things are happening. Hey, the Bible is real, and the mark of the beast is coming, and the New World Order is coming with it from the devil and all that. So then they will say, what do I need to get out of it, you know, to avoid this? And what do I need to overcome this? And that's when they would say, you know, I need to come to the Lord Jesus Christ. So it's a stepping stone for thousands or even hundreds of thousands or millions of people to become born again. So this is essential work in the body of Christ. And there's lots of people who say they're Christian that get into all this cardinal attacks. They don't like Alex Jones. That, you know, that people say, some people say he's a Jesuit, and some people say he's a supporter of Israel. All this nonsense, you know. And just like they do preachers. People criticize and attack preachers all the time for every little thing they might say that they don't agree with. They look for things they said wrong. There's even people that look at your hand gestures and say, ooh, that's a demonic sign you're making. You know, I believe there's lots of conspiracies, but, you know, even people that believe in conspiracies will say some people are really nuts. I mean, this is a conspiracies about conspiracies. You know, that even the people that's telling you about the conspiracies, they're also from the New World Order. I mean, anyway, brothers and sisters, let me finish the dream. So after Alex Jones was fixed, he fixed it. He fixed the lock and everything was cool. And then he was leaving. Now listen to this, it's very important, you know, and I pray that Alex Jones will hear this, or, you know, that we're going to pray for him. And I know he mentions all the time, he knows people are praying for him. But in my dream, brothers and sisters, and, you know, I pray that Alex Jones will hear this. When he went outside, he had to leave. He had to go to his house. He had to be home by 6 p.m. And I was like, what's going on? You know, and that's also like dark evening time, right? Darkness was coming. But he said, I had to go home because he had this ankle bracelet that he had to put on. And he was like under house arrest in his house. You know, I didn't get any interpretation other than that's probably literal. And so he had to get home because, the government was persecuting him, which we know that's coming. We know that persecution is coming. And in my dream, he had to go home and he had to put on this ankle bracelet and go home every night at 6 o'clock. And like he was under house arrest. And then I said, can I pray for you? I know you're busy, you know, and I'm busy with all the people from my YouTube ministry. But I know that, you know, you have millions of people listening to you and trying to contact you maybe. So do you have time for me to pray for you? And Alex Jones said to me, yes, of course, please pray for me. It's awesome, please. And so I grabbed his hands and I began to pray for him, brothers and sisters. And I could see myself praying, and it was like the words coming out of my mouth was from God. It wasn't me. I was like out of my body looking, and I was praying with him, and it's like it was God the one speaking to him. And in the Bible verse, and I was quoting all these Bible verses about, you know, no weapon formed against you shall prosper. Every tongue that rises up against you, thou shalt condemn. This is the inheritance of the saints of God, and their righteousness is of me. That's Isaiah 55:17. And, you know, the 23rd Psalm, the Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. And then Psalm 91, you know, which, you know, God will protect his people, you know, through famines and pestilences and all those things. And when I was saying that, brothers and sisters, a wind began to blow through the mansion. A wind of what I was saying began to blow through the whole mansion. And, you know, and it was like stirring up all the dust, all the deadness around there. And it was really like a revival and a new breath of fresh air into the whole mansion, the church. And then Alex Jones, of course, he was, just like he would be in real life. He was very grateful. He was thankful. And, you know, the Lord regenerated and renewed and revived his spirit, and he was so excited. And the message, the Bible verses I was quoting to him was that, you know, God gives us victory. We're going to prevail. We are going to prevail, brothers and sisters. The church, those who are really, you know, who are in the light, we will prevail over darkness. God gives, we have the victory through Christ Jesus. So this video is a call of prayer for brother. He is our Christian brother, Alex Jones. Even though he's not a pastor, and he's reporting the news of what's going on in the natural. This is a call to prayer for Brother Alex Jones, and I ask you to please do it.